A Geiger counter is an instrument that measures ionizing radiation. Jay Shelton explains how it works.
A Geiger counter has inside of it a Geiger tube, and a Geiger counter only detects ionizing radiation. That ionizing radiation knocks electrons off of atoms and molecules that it happens to encounter. So the detector has to be sensitive to that. So inside every Geiger counter, there is one or more Geiger tubes. The tube has a wire going down the middle and a metal can around the outside and kind of a special mixture of gases. So ionizing radiation comes along, it has to get through the metal and it will ionize some of the gas. There is a huge voltage difference between the wire and the can, which means if there's any charge in the air, it'll get very strongly. The electrons get pulled down to the wire and the positive ions get pushed out to the can. It's a very, very strong electric field. So if you create a bunch of free electrons, which is what ionizing radiation does, it knocks them out, the electron gets pulled very strongly towards the central wire. Now, of course, that ionizing radiation may ionize a few atoms, but here's the real key. You get amplification and you get a cascade. You get one electron, which is now loose from its atom, can start moving very fast towards the wire, and so fast that it itself becomes ionizing radiation. And when it bumps into another air molecule, it will knock an electron or two off of it. Now you have two, and they now get accelerated and they bump into another and you get more and more. You get a cascade of electrons being created by this process, that pulse of electrons hitting the wire. That makes a tick, makes a light blink, makes a counter go up by one. So it directly is detecting ions created by ionizing radiation, which of course is what we need.